What it do, ladies and gents? It's your boy, Gyro the Console Scrub himself. And today we're going to be playing some Battlefront. Motherfucking super creepy Jedi dude. Oh shit. Dude needs some plastic surgery. I mean, you would think, like, in the future, that much and shit, dude would be like, we gotta do something about, you know, my facial fucking region and all, cause it is fucked up looking. But anyways, we're gonna be, like I said, playing some Battlefront, playing some Supremacy, it looks like. I don't know, this gameplay is really old, and, I know I'm running around as an old-ass Palpatine dude. Fucking zapping people, don't even know how. Got a triple kill randomly. Oh my god. So, yeah. This is not a Battlefield video, but a Battlefront video, which a lot of people have just given this game so much hardcore criticism, and I can understand why in some aspects, of course, with per se some of the lack of content, because in this day and age, we have games that have unlockables out the ass. If you don't have just a gajillion hours worth of unlockables, then the game's per se garbage, you know? In quotation marks, as they say. But how I see it is, whenever I first ever played this game and actually started playing this game, it really kind of felt more or less kind of like a Bad Company 2 feel to it, because it was so just like friendly to the whole thing of who could aim in a quicker, sharper like fashion and be precise on time. Really didn't have anything to do with the whole like accuracy, because in Bad Company 2 you could just run around aggressive fucking recon people to death, and there's not much that people could do like other than have better aim than you and also be observant of their like surroundings. It's not saying that aggressive recons in Bad Company 2 ruin the game or anything like that, but you know, it was a lot more doable in that game, and so many more people love to actually run around as a sniper or recon class in Bad Company 2 than they do for Battlefield 3 or 4 or Hardline and so on and so on. But, like I said, Battlefront kind of felt like Bad Company 2 to me, because it was just really fast playing. You have to be on your shit or you will die quick, and you have to know your maps, of course. You have to know your cards and your weapons. You have to find like the weapons that work well for each map. You know, you just cannot run around with a DL-44 on every map and expect to dominate hardcore 90% of the time. They also just came out with the January update that hit on the 26th or 27th, I don't know, it's just like a day ago that it popped in, and they added a few new things. Wherever they added private matches, so now you and your friends can go play a private match of Battlefront, but you have to have at least 4 players to start the match. So I'm assuming that you can still run around and look. I haven't personally checked it out yet. I played a little bit of Battlefront yesterday here and there, but I just switched over to Forza 6 and raced my ass off. So anyways, in Battlefront, they also put some new multiplayer modes for the Tatooine map that was previously only accessible in the co-op survival mode, now known as Raider Cap. The map will be compatible with modes such as Blast, Droid Run, Drop Zone, Hero Hunt, and Heroes vs. Villains. So it is a smaller map that you guys can already, or could have already played in the co-op survival mode, and it is now in the multiplayer servers to play. Luke and Han Solo will also wear different outfits like they did actually on Hoth, and Luke even wields his original blue lightsaber. Hoorah! Now some people can stop fucking crying over Luke's fucking color of his lightsaber. Oh my god, shut the fuck up. Shit is so annoying. It's like the dumbest shit to fucking complain about in games. I mean, does the game play great? Yeah, game plays fucking great. Game looks great. But, you know, these helmetless fucking stormtroopers, you know? Oh my god, it's just like the dumbest complaint I've ever seen in some goddamn forums, you know? And just like, mass amount of people whine about shit. Sorry to get off the fucking... our point of what we're talking about. The, update that just came out, and I'm just totally ranting off when people cry. I don't know. I just really cannot go on to forums anymore of, like, any brand new games because it is just filled with just so many fucking whiny bitch babies. It's just like, shut the fuck up. You don't even know what a shitty game is, you know? I played some shitty games. You go back to, like, Nintendo days. Original Nintendo and Super Nintendo and all that. You go play some shitty games wherever you can't even play 5 minutes into the motherfucking game without dying just over and over and over and over and over and over and over. You know, and there ain't no fucking forums for you to go complain on because back in that day there was no goddamn internet. You know, so you kids don't even know what the fuck broken ass games are. These games are fantastic, amazing, wonderful. So also they will be back to the update. I'm still around like a motherfucker. I need to shut the fuck up. Alright, anyway, so they are going to be releasing other new stuff with the game, which they will be talking about later on in its free February update plans, which will include a new survival mission on Hoth, along with a brand new Hoth multiplayer map that will support our larger game modes, including Walker Assault, Supremacy, Fighter Squadron, and Turning Point. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I kind of ran it a little bit, and it's just random everywhere. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe.